Hello everyone, welcome to my channel. Today's episode is a tutorial for beginners. If you are just starting dot painting, then this video is just right for you. Dot painting is a very relaxing, meditative art form and is very easy to learn. You can master this art with lots of practice and few tips and tricks, and I am there to guide you in all steps of this journey. You can learn all about dot painting on my channel. Today I will tell you 5 things that you should avoid if you are a beginner. So let's start today's video. If you are new here, consider subscribing to my channel. When you just starting dot painting, then please don't use thin white paper for practicing. Initially you tend to use some waste paper cause you think anyways it is going to go in the dustbin. But I will advise you not to do that. White paper is very thin and is not good for dot painting. You will be discouraged by the result you get. Instead, you use some thick cardstock, more than 200 GSM, preferably dark color. You can cut those in rectangle shape for bookmarks or punch it for making gift tags. This way you can use them later and you can come back and check your first artwork. I have one more suggestion for this. We all have cereal boxes at home. You can cut them into squares and use this for practicing. They are very sturdy and best for practicing. Just find the center by making diagonal lines and start painting from the center. Number 2 is, don't use the paint directly from the paint bottle. Paints are not always in right consistency, and it's better to take out some paint and then use them. And your whole bottle of paint might get very thick if you leave them open for a long time. I will advise you to invest in these kind of small containers. They are available on Amazon. They are just perfect for mixing small quantity of paint. One more quick tip is to put little bit of Vaseline on the rim of the container. This way paint will not get dry and you can keep the paint for few months in them. Next thing is to never mix water in the paint. Most of the time paints are not in the right consistency to do the dot painting. Heavy body paints that comes in tubes are very thick and we have to make them thin to do the dot painting. For making the paint thin, don't use water. Use pouring medium instead. This way you will get the nice glossy pearl like dots. In the metallic paints you can mix just a drop of water, not more than that. If you mix too much water, your dots will crack after drying or you will see bubbles in them after drying. Number 4. Don't use Q-tips or earbuds. I know so many people say that Q-tips are very easy to use. I agree, if you are an expert, you can use any tool to do the dot painting. But if you are a beginner, then it will be frustrating to work with Q-tips. First, they absorb the paint and you don't get the pearl-like raised dots. Then you don't get the same size with Q-tips. Q-tips are best for wiping away your mistakes. It is better to use the back of the pencils or pens if you don't have dotting tools. I have already made a video on how to make homemade tools. You can watch that video, link is in the description. And the fifth thing is, don't use the tools with pressure. It's a very soft and gentle affair between your tools and the surface you are working on. If you use the tool with pressure and touch the surface all the way back, you will get the wrinkles on the dots. You have to touch the tools very softly and gently to the surface. Then you will get a beautiful pearl-like dot that you will love and appreciate. You can see here how I am doing it. See, you can see the wrinkle here. But if you do it softly 2-3 times, then you will get the raised nice pearly dot. Dot painting is a very relaxing art. It is proven that making dot art is meditative and it can calm you in many ways. It is very therapeutic and it is a great way to relax you in this time of pandemic. If you are inclined toward spirituality, I can suggest you heartfulness meditation. It is free of cost and on New Year, a mega online event is happening for new spiritual seekers. I will put that link in the description. You can try that out too. I hope you found this video useful. Stay tuned for more such videos in the future.